many reasons why the Thangjam Manorama case and the sexual violence against her really made it an important moment. When you look at it in terms of a longer history of encounters or extrajudicial killings in the context of army and police in India, so you can think about Kashmir, Northeast, Punjab at a particular period, right? Andhra, UP, Maharashtra. I mean, you can sort of find different contexts in which these extrajudicial killings have happened. But at the same time, what was striking there was that, of course, there was an iconic protest by the Meera Paibis who bared themselves in front of the army headquarters, Assam Rifles in this context, right? And that led to a moment where I think it impacted many, not just in the Northeast, but in sort of what they call the mainland Indian context as well, right? Typically, like once you're called a suspected militant, and this happens in many different contexts of the world, right? Depending on who you are, if you can be targeted and defined as a suspected militant, that is the end of the story. But what is really important to recognize is that we see on one hand an attempt to respond by, you know, setting up an inquiry commission, both into the AFSPA, Armed Force Special Powers Act, as well as what happened in Thangjam Manorama's case, right? The report itself ended up actually acknowledging that Assam Rifles and Major Dagar, who was there, was sort of responsible, right? Acknowledging that and basically totally rejecting the state narrative, right, or the military narrative. The report was never, basically brought out, right? It was never actually made publicly available until the Supreme Court sort of forced it in 2014. You know, the report was written in 2004. So I do think that tells you that, there was something revelatory about just holding the Assam Rifles person in responsible. But at the same time, we do have to look at what is the role then these inquiry commissions end up playing.